कैन यू ऑल गिव मी अ क्विक थम्स अप इफ माई ऑडियो वीडियो इज़ फाइन. सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ डर्मेटोलॉजी विद मी. आई एम डॉक्टर चेष्टा अग्रवाल, योर नीट पीजी एजुकेटर ऑन अन अकेडमी. दैट इज़ द बेस्ट ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ प्री पीजी एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन. नाउ टुडे इन द सीरीज ऑफ डर्मेटोलॉजी नीट पीजी कॉन्कर, वी आर टेकिंग अ सेशन ऑन पैपिलोस्क्वैमस डिसऑर्डर. नाउ बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द सेशन, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस सम ऑफ द सब्सक्रिप्शन ऑप्शंस इन अन अकेडमी. वन इज प्लस, विच गिव यू एन एक्सेस टू अन अकेडमी लाइव क्लासेस फ्रॉम द टॉप एजुकेटर. यू कैन एक्सेस द लाइव क्विजेस, टेस्ट, एंड यू कैन स्टडी ऑन द डिवाइस ऑफ योर चॉइस. देन वी हैव आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन विच गिव यू एन एक्सेस टू अन अकेडमी लाइव क्लासेस एज वेल एज इट ऑल्सो गिव यू एन एक्सेस टू प्रेप लेडर सब्सक्रिप्शन. नेक्स्ट इज वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ फ्री क्लासेस ऑन अन अकेडमी विच आर नोन एज स्पेशल क्लास. दीज क्लासेस कैन बी एक्सेस्ड यूजिंग अ रेफरल कोड चेष्टा 10. सो रिक्वेस्टिंग ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज यूज द रेफरल कोड चेष्टा 10 एंड गेट योर सेल्फ एनरोल्ड ऑन द बेस्ट ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म दैट इज अन अकेडमी. वी हैव अ हाईली इफेक्टिव क्वेश्चन बैंक ऑफ 25,000 प्लस क्वेश्चंस. दिस इज द लिस्ट ऑफ द टॉप लर्नर्स ऑफ नीट पी जी 2021. देन वी हैव रेज अ हैंड फीचर विच गिव यू अ स्पेशल बेनिफिट ऑफ आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस ड्यूरिंग अ लाइव क्लास. Now we have an Academy NEET PG test for December. There are a lot of rituals going on right now. So every Wednesday we have an educator curated test series. Then we have a FMG grand test, study with me YouTube test series. Then we have Saturday special class, marathon, grand test series, etc. And the paid subscriptions include a lot of batches which are going on right now. I request all of you to kindly use my code CHESHTA10 and get yourself or be a part of an academy. Now this is some of the new NEET PG 2022 packages. So we have a package which is starting from 10th December and it will go till 10th March. So that is a 3-month subscription, which is very, very important. And I request all of you to kindly use this. There's an additional benefit that you'll get a soft copy. You will have 13-week educator curated test. You have grand test, 24,000 plus questions, and if you use the referral code CHESHTA10, you will get the same thing in 11,200. Now another batch is for FMG students. It is a comprehensive batch and I will be the part of this batch. I'll be teaching dermatology. The course is starting from 13th. Now tomorrow An Academy is turning 6 years or having a 6 anniversary. So if you buy any of the An Academy subscription tomorrow, use the code CHESHTA10. So if you take a 1 year or longer subscription, 6 months will be free. So in the price of one year, you will be getting 1.5 year subscription. This is only valid for tomorrow. So I request all my dear students to please be a part of it. Don't forget to use this code. And we have another NEET PG combat which is scheduled for 19th of December, 5 p.m. where you get 45 questions and you have to solve them in 60 minutes. I request all of you to please use the code CHESHTA10. Please use the code CHESHTA10 and get yourself enrolled. This is the price list, requesting all of you to please subscribe an academy as early as possible. Use the referral code CHESHTA10. Today we have a very important discussion, and that is papillosquamous disorder. I've tried to compile all the questions of papillosquamous disorder together. So requesting all of you to please have a look on this question. Anyone can answer this one. Arrange the following stages of doing auspid sign in order of their time of occurrence in the test from earliest to the last. Anyone? Now please remember, auspid sign is a sign which we do for psoriasis, which is one of the most common papillosquamous disorder. Now what happens in auspid sign? We have total 3 step. Step 1, you require a scaly plaque. With the help of a glass slide, what do? You will scrape that plaque. With the help of a glass slide, you will scrape that plaque and this will cause accentuation of the scale. Whenever you have accentuation of skin, it gives you an appearance like that of a candle with a thick wax over it, known as candle grease or candle wax sign. In step 2, you will remove those scales. And what you see, you will see a thin shiny membrane which is known as Bulkley's membrane. In step 3, you will remove that Bulkley's membrane and you will see pinpoint bleeding areas. This is known as Auspitt sign positivity. This is known as Auspitt sign positivity. Now here a very very good image has been explained. So these are the histopathological changes. You tend to have suprapapillary thinning because the dermal papilla projects upward. There is a thick layer of stratum corneum because there is hyperkeratosis. So on scrubbing this layer, you will see a thin membrane which is known as Bulkley's membrane, and when you remove this, you will see the top part of the dermal papilla which is known as suprapapillary thinning. So I think now it becomes very easy that the step 1 is silvery scaly plaque. You will rub or garrotage those part or those plaques, then it is garrotage test. Then you will see Bulkley's membrane, so this becomes option number D, and finally you will have a pinpoint bleeding areas. So A, B, D and C is the correct answer here. A very important point is, it is absent in all those conditions, where the scales are absent, like flexural psoriasis, pustular psoriasis, erythrodermic psoriasis, etc. Ma'am, why this layer is thick? Shubham, please remember, the main problem in a patient of psoriasis is increased proliferation of the epidermis. So what happens, the epidermis, the only layer which proliferate is the stratum basal. It will quickly proliferate and reach up to the layer of stratum corneum. But because of delayed keratinization or delayed process of keratinization, these cells will keep on accumulating in the layer of stratum corneum, giving rise to thick stratum corneum. Understood? So the main pathogenesis is hyperproliferation of the stratum basal, and for this particular question the answer becomes option number 1. Next question is on your computer screen. It is an assertion and reason type of question. Anyone? The assertion and the reason type of question is given on your computer screen. Dermal melanin is seen in lichen planus. The reason is you have wedge-shaped hypergranulosis which is seen in lichen planus. Is it true or they are false? Very well done. Now remember that both these statements are true. You see dermal melanin in lichen planus, absolutely true. And you see wedge-shaped hypergranulosis in lichen planus. Both of them are absolutely true. But the reason for dermal melanin is not wedge-shaped hypergranulosis. The reason for dermal melanin is basal cell degeneration. You all know that the pigment-forming cell, that is melanocyte, they are present in the stratum basal. Melanocytes are present in the stratum basal. So whenever you have damage to stratum basal, the melanocytes or the melanin falls down into the dermis, giving rise to dermal melanin. And wedge-shaped hypergranulosis, which is seen, is responsible for the Wickham's striae. The white lacy pattern which is seen, it is because of wedge-shaped hypergranulosis. Please remember, the correct answer of this question is both are right, but they are not the correct explanation of each other. Soumya, you are right, it is option number 2, and Crystalina, you are also right, it is option number 2. So dermal melanin is seen in lichen planus and wedge-shaped hypergranulosis is also seen. Now let's discuss little more in detail about the histopathology of lichen planus. This is the 10x magnification. What are the changes? You can see that the stratum corneum is thickened, but it is without any parakeratosis, no nucleus. So it is hyperkeratosis without any nucleus, known as without parakeratosis. And very classical terminology is used for this condition, which is known as orthokeratosis. Very classical terminology is used, which is known as orthokeratosis. Next is, can you see that the stratum granulosum layer is thickened, but it is irregular? This is known as wedge-shaped hypergranulosis. Wedge-shaped hypergranulosis. Clear, all of you? Now, you can see that Ritter ridges are also very, very pointed. This is known as sawtoothing of Ritter ridges. And if you look at the dermoepidermal junction, you can see a lot of blue marks. This is known as band shape infiltrate, which is actually the T lymphocyte, which is the main culprit here. These T lymphocyte will cause inflammation at the dermoepidermal junction, causes the basal cell degeneration. So this is band shape infiltrate. Clear, all of you? I hope this is clear. So this is the 10x magnification of lichen planus histopathology. What about the 40x magnification of lichen planus? Now, we have discussed that the main problem is that the T lymphocytes goes and damage the stratum basale. So what exactly happens? Look at this image. There is hydropic degeneration of the cells of the stratum basale, and these degenerated keratinocytes will turn pink, and then they are called as colloid bodies, civet bodies, or cytoid bodies. So any of these terminologies can be used. Colloid body, civet bodies, and cytoid bodies. Clear, all of you? So this is the degenerated stratum basale. Now, with time, what happens? These colloid bodies get absorbed, leaving behind the empty spaces. Can you see these empty spaces? This is known as Max Joseph space. And through these Max Joseph space, the melanocytes or the melanin, which is present in the stratum basale, falls down inside the dermis, giving rise to dermal melanin. Clear, all of you? So this is the 40x magnification and this is the 10x magnification of lichen planus. Let's move to the next question. Anybody can tell me the answer of this question? Match the following type. Little difficult question, but I request Soumya and Kristalina to please try answering this question. Column A with the best alternative in column B. You have to match them. Okay. Now this is a little difficult question. You need to know about all these papillosquamous disorder. Starting with lichen planus, please remember lichen planus, if at all it is present on the scalp, it always heal with scarring alopecia. And scarring alopecia gives clinical appearance of footprint in snow. Scarring alopecia clinically gives appearance of footprint in snow. Clear, all of you? Next is reactive arthritis, which is also very popularly known as Ritter's disease. Seen secondary to patients of chlamydial urethritis. In these individuals, you can see succinate balanitis and keratoderma blennorrhagica. In seborrheic dermatitis patients, you tend to see cradle cap. In infants, we are talking about the infants where you tend to see cradle cap. And in pityriasis rubra pilaris, you see follicular keratosis. The correct answer is 1 for C. clear? So 1C, 2D, 3A and 4E is the correct answer of this particular question. Clear all of you? I think this is the easy one. Now we have another question. I request everyone to please answer this. Very, very nice. So you have to arrange these pre-malignant condition in order of their malignance potential, that is, which is more malignant and which is less malignant. So you have to arrange them in that order. Arrange the following oral lesions in the order of their malignancy potential from most to least. From most to least. Anyone can tell me the answer here? Very well done, all my dear students. The correct answer here is option number. Anyone? Very nice. Option number one is the correct answer. The first important point is erythroplakia is considered to be the most pre-malignant, followed by leukoplakia, followed by erosive or ulcerative lichen planus. And please remember, lacy lichen planus is not associated with any pre-malignant tendency. So Dr. M. Crystalina, you are absolutely right. The correct answer is option number one. I will quickly show you the images of each and every one of them. Look at this image. This is a very classical image of oral leukoplakia, whitish plaque on the palate. Then we have erythroplakia, which is the reddish plaque. You can see the ulceration in between. It has a great tendency to convert into malignancy, but it is least common. And whenever you see a purple hue around the ulcer, this is a case of lichen planus. So these are the few pre-malignant conditions which are seen in the oral cavity. So with this, we are done with the today's session. I thank you all my dear students for the patience listening. I request all of you to please join in this class. We have a lot of sessions coming up and going on also. I request all of you to please join Let's Crack Neet PG, the Unacademy YouTube channel, free of cost. Another is, we have a Telegram group with the same name. You can also follow the group with for more details of the classes, the access or the link of the class, lecture notes, etc. If you want to subscribe to Unacademy, I request all of you to please use my code, that is Cheshta10, and get yourself enrolled. If you like my class, I request you to press the bell icon as well as press on the thumbs up. Please watch my class regularly for detailed discussions of dermatology. I will be coming every day for such interesting short topics. Let me know in the comment section if anything you want me to discuss. So I'll definitely try to make a class on that. So bye bye all of you. Take care and good day.